In this week's episode, we're going to take a look at Cura 4.7. It was just recently released, and I found a feature in it they didn't even advertise. So let's take a look at what changed and that hidden feature on today's Filament Friday. Filament Friday is brought to you by these Patreon supporters. So here's proof. I'm looking at the latest version, version 4.7.0. This isn't the beta, this is released. I brought in this Iron Man model that I used before to show manual supports, but here's the new feature, rotation. They've added these arrows to the rotation circles. Now you can change it like you could before, just grab it and drag it, and it'll turn like 15 degrees. But the arrows were added because now when you click on the arrow, it automatically turns 90 degrees in the direction that you're clicking on. So here I am clicking on the green and it's flipping this guy 90 degrees. I click on the red, right on the arrow. You got to click on the arrow and it'll turn 90 degrees. So that's a new feature they've added to version 4.7. The next change involves tree supports, which has always been there, but they've brought in tree supports into the main menu. It used to be experimental. So now when you click on generate supports, you have two choices, normal supports like you're used to, or click on that and then you have tree supports available. So when you click on tree supports, then you have all the settings for tree support. So it'll come out like this. It looks like branches of a tree and you can make it so it doesn't touch the base. So it'll like grow around your design. But if you go to normal, then it's straight up supports. So that's like it always was. The only difference is they moved it from a tree from experimental to now up here to the main support menu. So that's handy. There's a few changes in post-processing that they made, kind of minor, but I really like them. Let me show you those. For reference, let's look at version 4.6 of Cura. If I go up here to extensions, post-processing, modify G-code, I get these scripts that I can add. And there's all kinds of posit height. There's posit height, there's posit height for BQ printers, posit height for rep wrap, and one for repeteer. Well, in 4.7, they combined all that. So now if I go into add a script, there's only one posit height. And then when you go into that, there's a drop down for the different methods. M0 delay, M25 delay, M226, depending on what your printer needs. I like that. Let's stay with version 4.6 for a second. There's a post-processing change at Z5.1.1 experimental. You can change flow rate, you can change extrusion temp, speed at a certain height. With this, you can make a temperature tower. Let me show you that. So here's a CHEP cube. I'm going to start out printing at 205 degrees C. Then at 5 millimeters, I'm going to set it to 200 degrees C. Then at 10 millimeters, I'm going to change it to 195. And at 15 millimeters, 190. And then print this, and it'll change. So it's very, very handy. In 4.7.0, they've updated it a little bit. It's now version 5.2.1. One of the changes, they combined two blocks into one, just if you want it only at the layer or subsequent layers. They've added output to display, and they've also added a retraction option. Pretty nice. Here's a feature that I didn't see advertised anywhere. In fact, I found it by accident. It's manual supports without using the plugin. I've showed the plugin in a previous video. This is manual supports without any plugin. It's built right into 4.7. Let me show you how it works. So let's use Iron Man again and come over here to the support menu. I've got generate support unchecked. Therefore, there's no parameters to set, right? So I click on the model. Then I click on support blocker and you can put a block where you don't want supports. But in my case, I want supports right under his hand right here. Well, what you can do is select a block, not the model, just the block, and then come down to this menu and select print as support. This is available in previous versions, but notice now all the parameters show up so I can adjust that support. This wasn't available in previous versions. So now I can adjust everything. So when I slice this guy, it's going to slice and it's going to put a support right there where that block was. And now I can adjust those parameters easily. Let's switch to material color so you can see this is the support it's going to be printed. I can adjust the spacing. I can adjust, you know, the gap between the support and the arm, all right here on the side, because all those support settings are easy to see. So that's a new feature they didn't mention, at least nothing that I could find. And there you have it. That's my introduction to version 4.7 of Cura. I'm going to keep playing with it to see if I can find any other hidden features they didn't advertise. In fact, I'm getting some of the best prints out of 4.7 with my 4.6 profiles. So I didn't even create new profiles, and I seem to be getting better prints. I'll explain more about that in a future video. But right now, I'm going to go back and play with it some more and see if I can find any hidden gems. So that's it for this week. If you like what I'm doing here, maybe check out some of the videos that are popping up. And if nothing else, click on that CHEP logo and subscribe. I'll see you next time right here at Filament Friday.